Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Why am I down here? Well, my camera was low on battery, so I had to come down and save the game so I could quit the game, and I'll just see you back when I'm up top. There I go. There's the elevator music. Alright, so let's see what's behind this door that I unlocked at the end of the last part. Well, there's enemies, I can guarantee that. Oh, jeez. Oh, no. Cannot go through sprites like that. Well, on the ground, yeah. Uh-oh. Oh, no, shoot. I didn't know I would bounce off the switch. I never tried that before. Oh, well. Let's see here. It would probably be in my best interest to flip the Koopas. But it would also be in my best interest to prevent damage. So, yeah, I think I'm just going to do it like this. And then just guard their attacks. Oh, I'm trying to do super guards just to be all fancy about it, even though it's kind of costing me because of their very, very strict timing windows. Anyway, now I'm going to multi-bounce, I suppose, because that'll flip them over. I just wanted to reduce the damage of the dull bones, basically. And I could have just ran from this battle as well, but I have a feeling that they would get in my way tremendously if I didn't. Because, yeah, I'd be messing around in that switch area. Oh god. Oh god, no! Oh, my audience! No, my adoring fans! Oh no. Well, it doesn't happen often, but it happens. Just gotta plan for that, I suppose. I'm not all that worried about my health, in all honesty. There is that block a little while back, and, you know, the block to recover your health and whatnot, so yeah, if it gets crazy, I've also got mushrooms, and anyway, let's just move on from here. So that, hitting that block moved that block down there, which means I've got to do one of these dealios again. Bloop! Up we go! And now look at this. Look at this little tiny ledge that you can go onto, because you are paper thin, but be mindful to be very, very careful not to fall off. Just make sure your control stick is straight and calibrated before you do this. My shadow's off the edge there. Let me go through, thank you. But I want to go like that, align myself, because I need the star piece. Must get all 100. Must 100% game to OCD standards. Must use paper airplane to get to door. So go carefully. And there you go. Okay, that wasn't all that carefully, but I don't really have to be careful with that because you don't have to be mega precise. Over here is something really nice. Oh well, I shouldn't say it's really nice, but it's actually something really annoying. First, there's this. The castle key, you obviously have got to get that. But remember that I said there's a badge below in this room that you couldn't get until later? Well, now you can get it using that yellow block. But here's the issue. You can hit this block like that, but you can't like hold Koops on this side in order for you to get this block to raise back up. So we have ourselves a little conundrum here. You have to drop the block, drop down here, get the badge, which is the last stand, last stand partner badge, and then you have to go all the way back up to the top, so I'll see you there. Oh, wait. Now I'll see you there. And here we are. Back at this door, which means I don't need to take the lower path. Now that I got the key, I can go straight to the upper path. And get the shine sprite! There we go! That's the last one of Hooktail Castle, by the way, so you don't have to worry about any more of those. Whoop. Let's go through here. And oh. Oh no, you don't! Ooh, change in atmosphere. Look at that awesome background. The paper background, oh yeah. That is sweet. The whole thing is, I mean, the whole game is made out of paper, but I mean, it just looks like really cool artwork. And keep going, keep going, keep going. I don't think there's anything in here that you can find by jumping around. If I recall correctly. Just keep going. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. That one was pretty hard to avoid. But you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to do this. Bye-bye. And I get as many coins back as I can. There we go. Oh, well. I think I'm getting greedy. Okay, I'll just leave that one. Oh, here's another healing block here. But I'm going to save my game and go inside. Remember, just remember to have the Attack FXR badge equipped. This one right here, the one that you got from earlier room. Yeah, make sure you have that one equipped. Then go through this door.
Who dares approach me?
Oh shoot, I should have switched to Goombella. Paper Dragon! It's like Chinese New Year!
So you are friends of the strange garbed one who came earlier. I didn't expect more to come to steal this the treasure I protect. Such rashness. That was foolish, I fear. Do you really think you can beat me? But you're so small, and don't appear tasty. I suppose you might make a good snack. And the bottoms of your feet smell like they might make a good sauce with some spices. What I'll do is saute you to crispy goodness and gobble you down head first!
And this is the wow, the boss of the area.
Hooktail, snack time, little appetizers. But which of you morsels shall I taste first?
Love his theme song, by the way. So, this is why you want to have the badge equipped. Because if you don't have it equipped, he'll be able to attack you normally. But when he hears the sound of crickets,
awful sound. Sounds like a cricket. How did you know? Stop that this instant.
I got really bad food poisoning once when I ate a cricket. I hate them. Oh, fight it, Hooky. Just hearing a cricket chirp makes me feel woozy. Without that, without doing that cricket chirp thing with the badge, he's got 5 attack power and 1 defense, but having that badge equipped will cause him to have both of those stats drop. Oh, poopers. Yeah, it's down to 3 rather than 5, so it's much, much more manageable. Anyway, the reason why I switched to Goombella was obviously so I could tattle, and that's why I wanted to have Goombella out at the start of the fight, but I kind of made a mistake there, and I just rushed in without thinking of switching partners. Anyway, that's Hooktail! Max HP is 20, attack is 5, and defense is 1. It'll stomp and munch on you, and has more dragonish attack. Stinky, fiery breath. It's tricky, especially when it's losing, and it'll try to fool you into being merciful. Oh yeah, and one more thing. It hates things that start with CR and ends with Icket.
Well, it's too late if you're in the battle.
Supposedly there's something related to that somewhere in the castle. Did we find it?
Yes, we did. You should actually know this, because if you were paying attention. Anyway, I've got some good recovery items here, so I should be fine for the most part in this battle if I just use regular attacks. Not to mention I've got the star power to recover stuff.
Oh, that's not gag. My poor tummy. So very woozy.
Oh, geez, stage hazard. Wait, oh, that's actually good. Because that'll make him get hurt when I get hurt. Well, when Mario gets hurt, oh, poor Goombella. Got squished, got crumpled. I'm going to switch back to Mario because she was in the front lines and she doesn't have all that much HP. And yeah, just strategy here. Wah! Down to 15 already. And yeah, I'm pretty sure I can happily do a head bonk on his Tootsie because his defense is dropped. That's kind of tricky to time, man. I'm out of practice. But it's okay. I have plenty more in my arsenal. I should say plenty to go in my arsenal to protect myself from doom. Anyway,
gonna keep attacking like no one has attacked before. Yeah, you can also attack his nose, but I don't think it matters really which thing you attack, because it just doesn't seem to make any difference as to whether you attack its head or its foot, basically. So do whatever it is that makes you feel comfortable, is what I'm saying. I personally like attacking his Tootsie. When he's on the ropes, though, something different happens. Oh, you notice his attack power really dropped to the point that it's not even doing much damage. And wait, I want that. Yes, that was an audience member trying to throw me an item, and if I would have pressed the X button, I would have hammered it away from it. And I actually pressed the Y button instead of the X button out of panic, so I'm actually glad that I hit the wrong button. Hooah! And... oh, shoot, I wanted to do the Tootsie, but that's fine. It's on the 1 HP. What did I get from that? Oh, no. Alright, let's attack! Knock him out!
Wait, hold up a moment. I give up, please. I won't be so bad anymore, I promise. In fact, I'm sorry for everything. To prove it, I'll give you 1,000 coins. What do you say? Can you forgive me?
Keep your coins, fiend.
What?
You must be joking. You don't need any coins. Then how about the lovely, rare, extra special badge I have? I'll give you that. It's one of a kind, and it's yours for a limited time only. Will you take it?
Sure, why not?
Of course you want it, who wouldn't? Now come here and get your badge. Obviously you don't want to do that. I just wanted to show that for the fun of it. Like, if you believe him and just agree to what he does, you'll take damage from that.
Oh, you are completely duped by my ingenious ruse.
Coward!
You senseless yokels, nothing in life is that easy. Your gullibility did you in.
This isn't looking so good. I guess I'd better,
not the audience, no!
Yeah, he also recovers his HP if you, quote-unquote, believe him as well. I just wanted to show this. Obviously, it is in your best interest to decline all of his offers. But for the walkthrough, I thought I would show you this.
That's just terrible!
Now my strength has returned to me.
That's it, enough of this. Let's finish him off once and for all, Mario.
Into the audience!
And I actually should be recovering, but although I'll do it with Goombella, because I just gotta start cricket chirping again to get his attack power down again.
Why do I have to feel so faint every time I hear cricket?
So yeah, I'm going to item up. Again, this, you wouldn't really have to worry about this sort of thing if you didn't believe him, is what I'm saying here, but this is just for fun. For the walkthrough, gotta show some stuff like that. It's all for the good times of showing stuff, and yeah. Anyway, let's keep going.
He's almost done. No more believing him. Whoops.
There we go. And there we go. Bloop, bloop. No fire breath, though. Okay. Ugh! By the way, when he does the fire breath, you gotta kind of time your button presses in time. Oh! Stage hazard! Why? The stage... with the timing of the fire breath. Just imagine the fire coming in contact with you, then your partner in that timing, and then you'll kind of get the hang of it, but it's kind of tricky in all honesty. Anyway, he's down!
How? Why? This is so much I wanted to do with my life. So many meals.
Love this boss. And he flips over on his belly. Oh, two away. Maybe I shouldn't have ran from that battle.
Yes, we did it, Mario.
By the way, when your partner is low on HP, they appear like that outside battle.
All you have to do now is search for that crystal star. We can't seem to locate.
Whoa, who is this? Yeah, I'm out! I'm finally out!
Whoa! It can't be.
Eh?
Dad!
Hey, you're Koops! Hey, son, you've gotten so big since I saw you last.
Well, yeah, I guess I have, but who cares, Dad? I mean, golly, what happened to you? Where have you been all this time?
Well, I came here a while back to deal with Hooktail, and all was well and good. But just before my finishing blow, he played a trick on me and gobbled me down whole. I've been hiding in my shell for 10 years since then, inside Hooktail's belly. And boy, was it nasty. Yuck! I'm so glad to finally get out.
He's such a cheerful guy for being in his belly for such a long time.
Honestly, Dad, do you know how worried about you we all were? For 10 long years, we all thought we thought your game was over.
Oh, sorry, son, but I'm okay. That's good, right? We're together now, right?
Hey, speaking of which, what are you doing here anyway?
Oh, come on, Dad. I came here to defeat Hooktail, who's been wrecking havoc in this town. And Mr. Mario here is looking for a gem called the Crystal Star.
Crystal Star? That wouldn't be what you were talking... This wouldn't be what you're talking about, would it? What's that?
I found it down there in Hooktail's belly. Nice, huh? I kept it as a souvenir.
So, this is the thing you're looking for.
Perfect. Just perfect. You can have it.
Me? Mario's like.
Come now, I won't take no for an answer. You're Koops' friend. Please take it.
I got a crystal star!
And a new move to go along with it, known as Earth Tremor.
The chapter is over!
Mario and friends finally got a crystal star in the castle after defeating Hooktail. Koops even reunited with his long-lost father, whom he thought was dead. Yet they were unable to learn anything about the whereabouts of the princess. Where could Princess Peach be?
I wonder.
Perhaps we'll find that out in the next part. I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you then.